Well, good evening, YouTube. Today, May the 9th, 2015, is the official start of campfire season at Troll Forge. Zed Outdoors is doing a contest. There'll be a link in the description. And what he wanted was for people to get outdoors and cook. Well, for us, this is a fairly regular thing in the summer. Been a hard day at work. Don't feel like heating up the house. Don't feel like going to a lot of effort in cooking. So we light the campfire and have, well, tonight's gonna be hot dogs and marshmallows. So, just watching the fire, because I'm sure you can't see me in the shadows here. For that matter, you can see the hot dog in the fire. Thought I'd tell the story. It is one of the first questions everybody asks. Why Troll Forge? Well, back in the 70s, a couple of buddies of mine and I used to get together and play role-playing games. And when Dungeons & Dragons came out as a series of articles in Dragon Magazine, we started playing that. Now, when I started high school, I got fed up with having to share a bedroom with my little brother. So I hung Persian rugs and wool blankets on the wall in the unfinished basement and moved down into the basement. Well, the basement of my parents' house is also where we used to usually get together to play Dungeons & Dragons. And the guys had got to calling the basement at my place the Troll Hole. And when I moved downstairs and started living there, well, if I'm living in the Troll Hole, that must make me the troll. So I've had the nickname of trolls since about 78, because long before the internet, long before the current meaning of the word troll. And then around about 1990, I was at a farm auction, and a buddy of mine bought a refrigerator at the farm auction and didn't have a way of getting it home. So he asked if I'd put it in my truck and bring it home for him. He said he knew I was a welder, so he said, "Look, I know you're into metalworking. I'll trade you a Civil War era Farrier's Forge for your effort in bringing the refrigerator home for me." So I said yes, and Troll Forge was born. I have run Troll Forge as an actual business until 20 years ago when my daughter was born. And we decided to move off the farm and move into my ex-wife's grandmother's house to take care of her. I haven't had the forge up running as anything but a hobby since. But had the email address of trollforge@yahoo.com since before internet access was available. We had to phone into, using a dial-up modem, phone into a Blackboard service, and then from there we could log into Yahoo. So I've had more years of Trollforge as my email address than is, I guess, that was 82, 83. So here's my supper over the campfire, a little story to go with it. Time to eat. Thanks for watching.